Hey, cloud backup is a very good way to backup your data. Well, I was using Windows Mesh before, but as Microsoft is going to discontinue for some reason, now I have to switch to SkyDrive. Why I don't like SkyDrive is I have to move that folder into SkyDrive and I have to reorganize my file structure. But to avoid that, I found a way. Now let's discuss how it can be done. Now let's see how normal it is done in SkyDrive. First, we'll create one new folder and put some file in it, and we'll try to synchronize it in SkyDrive the normal method. So we'll create new folder on desktop, and then we put some files like a text file or something there, some Word file maybe. In order to synchronize that folder into a SkyDrive cloud, we have to move that folder inside existing SkyDrive folder. So that folder is almost ready. We'll move it into SkyDrive folder, and this is how it is synchronized. We can check file, this file synchronized or not, can be seen on SkyDrive online website. This is how it is normally done. You have to move your folders into one particular folder and disturb your folder architecture. But there is another way, a simpler way. There is one extension to make it really simple. That extension is called SkyShell. The extension is very tiny inside, but it is wonderful application. First, install this SkyShell. It's a very tiny software, and it is very simple. You can download 64-bit or 32-bit extension according to your system, your own system. The setup is almost done, and this is where you can find those extensions, 64-bit and 32-bit both. Yeah, this is a SkyDrive of the developer. There is 64-bit available and even 32-bit beside them. Keep in mind, the initial version is really handy and good. The latest version, I find it somewhat complex. So this is the developer, Jen Hanman, the good man, who has developed this extension, and it is very efficient. So our extension is almost, no, it's completed. So we'll check it, how it is working. It is working for us or not. Let's see. In this extension, we only have to right click on the folder we want to synchronize, like new folder, right click, sync to SkyDrive. Yes, that's really how simple it is. And you can see this SkyDrive, there is a file is also there, new, and we can create some new files, so we can check if it is synchronizing it. Yeah, see, in SkyDrive also that file is synchronized. We'll create some more file. See, this file is also synchronized in SkyDrive also, and in local computer also. We'll move some heavy files in. Okay, so UM which file is transfer in that folder, and in SkyDrive folder also that is synchronized. Let's see the property of the SkyDrive. Now it is giving you KB. Well, and our actual data is in MB, and the SkyDrive folder is only in KB. So really the file is not moved in this folder. The folder location and folder structure is as it was before, and SkyDrive in SkyDrive there is only one illusion, one shortcut is there that actually that makes our data synchronized in our this data is really synchronized. It is uploaded here. Even though in SkyDrive folder there is a few KB data, the actual data is what we expected. All the data is stored here. It can be seen here. It is synchronizing actually right now. It will take some time, but it is happening. Few files also we can see here. If you want to detect that synchronization, you have to only right click and delete. This will not delete your actual folder, just a shortcut created for synchronization from the SkyDrive. So you can check that in this account again there is only 0 KB file, because it was a shortcut actually, it was not a real folder. So this is how it is done. You only move or create a shortcut of your original folder, or the original folder stays there where it was, and you can synchronize any folder. You just right click and synchronize to SkyDrive. Extension link is in description if you want to download it. Thank you.